Hey there, Biz 414 here, back on the V for Vanilla server, and I'm here today in my Savannah base, on the roof of my little starter house. You can see over there I've been working on my road back to the desert base. I still need to do the bridges. I'm going to have a little bridge connecting from there to here. You can kind of see I've got a makeshift temporary sandstone bridge there. I might transition the road to something different here instead of using that. We'll see. I'm not going to work on the road today, though. I want to work on getting a place set up for my horses. So I can bring a horse over here and start riding a horse back and forth, which I already do. But when I get here, I just park him in this little hole, which isn't a great house for a horse. I want to put a stable in back in here somewhere. And I'm thinking I'm going to do it right here. There's like this natural little indentation and like overhang right here. And I think that'd be a really good spot for my stable. I could have like part of the building, like the front fascia of a building sticking out right here maybe. And have just a big, as much space as I need on the inside. And I could have like a little road that goes through here and cuts in between this mountain peak and this mountain peak and connects over to there. So I think that's what I'm going to try to do, what I'm trying to work on. Something else that I need to do is get rid of all this sand. I don't want to have sand on my savanna biome mountain base. I want to have this nice grass. So I'm going to have to remove a lot of the sand, replace it with dirt and stone and whatnot. That's a big off-camera project, but I did start doing it right there. This little mound right there was all sand. I just converted it to dirt, and I'll probably go through after the fact and add a little bit of stone and maybe some diorite or andesite, maybe even granite here and there. Just to make it so it's not just all dirt, but we'll see. That's like a finishing touch type of thing. But what I need to do is I need to go back to the desert base to grab a beacon. So I want to set up a beacon here so that I can dig into that mountainside a lot quicker and also get some regen going when I need to, so I don't have to keep on wasting potions. Go ahead and head back home. Well, to our other home. And while we're doing that, we can also go ahead and check out this road that I built along the way. It's not any different than the road that I did to spawn and the roads that I helped work on in spawn. A combination of cobble, mossy cobble, polished andesite, stone slabs. But it's nice. It winds through the savanna, and I think it's mostly all that's here is just savanna. I don't think that it runs through any other biomes. Maybe just like a plains biome? I don't remember. Let's find out. It's a pretty quick trip. Actually, it's not too bad. My two bases are relatively close to each other. And by horse, it's really, really fast, like just like 30 seconds or 20 seconds or so to get back and forth. So not too bad. Watch out for the creepers over here. Zombies. There's some nice scenery along the way that I'd like to enhance a little bit, draw attention to, like, let's take a little trip, backtrack a little bit, like those two caverns right there. I don't know what I would do with them. Maybe just put a little bit more stone around them so that they stick out a little bit more, and put a light source inside so that, like, when you're coming along the path, you just see this, you know, a little bit of light in those caverns over there. Just a little extra visual flair. It's an example of some of the little things I would like to do along some of these paths I've been making as I have time to do so. And this path especially, I really tried to follow the terrain a little bit more. Ow. And, whoa! I didn't mean to make you mad. I'm sorry. Must have accidentally shot at him. I don't know. I didn't even see him. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I'm trying to stay with the train. So we've got some little hills here and there. Nice. I'm gonna just kind of avoid that witch over there. All right, and home is just over this hillside. Yep, there's our desert. And I didn't do the path over here on the desert side, because I need to get some more ice. I'm gonna go ahead and put ice underneath of it and do the slab path like I did in the rest of the desert. And I didn't do a bridge here either, because I can walk across this. It's only one block deep, so I can walk across it even with my horse. But yeah, this path I've got to dig one deeper and put in ice blocks, and then cover it with my slab roads like I have over there. Let's go ahead and get into the village here. Ow! Run away. Oh, get to see a guy meet his end. Very nice. We gotta go down here anyway. Get some iron for our beacon. Very nice. No, you don't go there. You go here. Shoot. And just rearrange some of these a little bit. That's fine. Alright, so we've got. How much iron do I have here? Quite a bit. Almost a full stack. Alright, and I've got more up in the house, along with another beacon. Oops. Plenty of villagers here too. Something else that I do want to do here, I'm not going to do it today, but I'm thinking about doing like a villager trading hall here. I don't know if I want to do it here or if I want to do it at the new base. I don't know how I feel about moving all my villagers over. Where did I put my beacon? It's somewhere. Is it in here? No. Here. Here. Well, let me look around and see if I can find that. And I'll probably actually just meet you back over at the new base. All right. Alrighty, we're back. I got enough iron to do a full beacon, plus the beacon. I had it in my secret hiding place. And I think for now, this isn't going to be the permanent place to set it, but I think for now I'm just going to set it up on top of this hillside. I kind of wanted to go up here anyway just to see what was up here, since I'm going to be putting my, what's it called? My stable here. This might not be as thick as I think it is. Huh. Maybe this side would be better, but I've got my little lake over here. Let's see, let's get over here. See if I can get to a position where I can see that under part. Let's go over there. Yeah, it's right there. Yeah, if I dig into there, it's pretty much just going to be a tunnel straight out to the other side, which isn't really what I want. Maybe I could put it right there. There's another little nook right there. So I could have it sticking out there, maybe. Or maybe have two entrances to it. I'm not sure. Either way, beacon can still go right here. It should reach pretty much everywhere around here. At least everywhere that I'm currently working. I'm not planning to go very low right now, so it's okay that it's not down at bedrock level. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This tree's gonna have to go. 8, 9. Need my pick. Thank you. We have to dig out a little bit of dirt. And let's go ahead and get this tree too. All right. More iron blocks. Stay there. That one too. It's fine. Right, and next layer. So nice having an iron farm. I still don't have one in my single player. How I've lived so long without one. Almost done. There we go. And the piece de resistance. And for now, we want to do haste two. Da-da-da-da. Food. Eating bread for now. Alright. Let's go ahead and get back down. Whee! Alright, so I wonder. I think that this is pretty narrow too. Let me look here. I've got a tunnel here. No, we could go into this in this direction and have some of it underneath of this hillside. Oops. Hop. Hi-ya. Oh, didn't make that one. There we go. Yeah. I think that's what I'll do. Maybe make it inside of this hillside. Got this little valley here that I don't necessarily know what I will do with. Maybe underworld entrance, not sure. Like mining area, again, not sure. Yeah, I think we'll maybe try to put our barn underneath of this hillside. So that would be still kind of underneath of this ledge. Hurt. Probably like right around in here. I could have like one side of it up against this, or even remove a little bit of this as needed. I want to kind of try not to destroy the landscape completely here. I really like this mountain, so I want to try to do stuff that enhances it, not breaks it. I hear a skeleton. Where are you? So yeah, so I think this is I think where we'll do this. We've got a pretty decent sized hill that we can cavern out here for our purposes. I basically just want to have a pretty decent sized interior and just have very minimal fascia here. So I'm going to work on that a little bit off camera, work on starting the front of this here and dig out some more of this, and I'll be back when I've made some progress to show you. Welcome back. So I've been working off camera for quite a bit, off and on for a few days here, and I think I'm pretty much finished, more or less. I might have a couple little things to do. I know I need some sea lanterns. I'll point out where in a moment. But here is the reveal. So if, let's say we come riding in, and don't mind my mess, I was growing some acacia trees. So I'm riding in to my savanna biome into the mountains, and let's pretend that there's a road here, because I haven't finished it yet. So let's pretend we're riding down our road. We come over here and we want to park our horse. We come through this little pass, and here we are, our barn. It's nice and red. I started out using the diorite for it, like I did on that. It just didn't look right. I was telling myself it was okay because there are white barns. Not all barns are red, but it just didn't feel right. It didn't feel like a barn. So I changed it, and now we have this guy right here. I'm digging it. It's built into the hillside here. Up at the top, it kind of looks like the mountain has fallen on the roof of it a little bit or something. So I'll probably, right here in this corner, maybe put some gravel and coarse dirt and stuff right here. You won't really be able to see it too much from down here. Just a tiny little bit right there, probably. But from up there, it'll look really neat. And I sucked back this overhang quite a bit. It used to come out to like here, I think, and all the way over to like right there. So I just shaved it back just a little bit so that you had a little bit more of a view of this thing coming in. I didn't want it to be completely hidden. So the way that you get into it is this button right here. And this is the 3x3 piston door that I use in my single player. That's a mumbo jumbo design. I'll try to remember to put a link in the description for that. Got a little owie there. Usually shouldn't happen. But yeah, it's a very fast door. I've got downstairs, I've got a little bit of a delay so that I have time to get in. But once we're inside, we've got this little like an entry area. And then we've got the stables here. And I just went with a very simple design. You can click the button there, park your horse, and hop out. Since they're too wide, they won't walk past there. You can walk right in. I was going to try to have something where I would have had... Let me grab... Oops, I don't want that on. Let me grab my pick. I was going to do something where I had a gate here, or a trapdoor here, and a trapdoor, excuse me, back up please sir, thank you, a trapdoor there. Oh, I guess that does work. Ooh, I didn't think that worked. I suppose I didn't test it, did I? Okay, well I might go through and grab some extra trap doors and put them like that so that I have a whole bar going across. I may not though, just because as it is, I can just walk right out. I suppose if I had one of these guys here, get back. I could jump right over it as well. Where the heck is the skeleton or spider at? He's not in here, is he? It should be bright enough that there's no monsters in here. He must be outside. But yeah, I may come through and put an extra trap door here. Not sure. It functions as is. It's pretty nice. And getting the horse out is just as quick. Hop on him, flick the button. Out you go. I'm just being impatient with this. If you wait a minute, just a second, you can get through without hurting yourself. Get in there. You're embarrassing me. Yeah, see now, usually if I had to flick the button to come out, he might follow me out. But like I said, I could jump over the low ones. Anyway, so what we've got is we've got 8 stables in each section. So we've got one section here, and then we've got another little doorway here, and then another section. And then I stopped it here. I looked, and I believe that I might be able to add one more section in here if I wanted, but it would probably start to poke out the backside of the hill, and I'd have to either build up the backside of the hill or embrace having the roof and facade of this thing exposed on the other side too, which I don't really want. I want just that one front side to be seen and the rest of it to be inside of here, like hidden in the mountainside. So here's where I need the sea lanterns. We don't have a guardian farm yet, so I might just have to go to a guardian farm and swim around and kill some little baby guardians to get some more of these things. I don't need that many more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more. So not bad, but I only had 2. So these little areas are just a couple of little storage areas. We've got a bunch of chests, ender chests just in case. Same thing over here. Floor is slightly different over here. Same materials, just a different pattern. And then I've got this repeating pattern going through here. Again, this should be sea lanterns. And then it would look identical to this. And they all connect. It's pretty neat. I kind of like this floor design. Personally, a little fancy for a barn, but I think it looks nice. And in the stables themselves, I've just got some hay, some sand. It's supposed to look like their bedding, horsey bedding. And roof, we've got red brick plus some hardened clay. And that's about it. Oh, upstairs, we have a little loft for our hay. Now, I'll probably store hay down here, but if I wanted to, I could store it up here. I could throw a couple shelves, chests up here, and store some actual hay bales inside of chests up here. But really, this is just for looks. It's just aesthetics. I've got some light hidden here and there underneath of these yellow carpets. So it's nice and bright up here. And you can kind of see the straw from outside, this one especially. And I definitely wanted it so you could see it, oops, from down here, which you can. So, and I can always stack those up a little bit higher if I feel like this isn't visible enough. See, I'm pretty satisfied with this. I've got plenty of room in here. 16 total bays, which I currently have 3 horses, a mule, a donkey, and a horse. So I've got plenty of room for expansion going forward, which is good because this is supposed to be my permanent base. And yeah, that's about it for this build and for this episode, probably. I think that what... Did you close? Okay. Sometimes you get a little bit of lag with the pistons running on the server. I think next time what we'll do is I'll probably try and get some of my animals moved over here. Get my my donkey and my mule brought over here. Maybe bring some luggage with them. I do need to start transporting some of my inventory, my stock from the starter base over to that little hut, because I've been making so many trips back and forth between the two bases getting things. It's rather annoying, so I need to start having, you know, more of my building supplies over here. I'm going to be doing a lot more building here than back at the old place, at least for now. So yeah, it for me for today. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.